Guess what, real world travelers? We are on spring break! Woo! So yesterday was our last day of teaching, and then this morning we are on our way to Hiroshima. Hiroshima is not our only stop on this spring break trip, but you'll just have to keep watching the vlogs to find out where we're gonna go next. Oh, we made it on our bullet train. We got to the station about 20 minutes before our train was supposed to leave. We ended up getting unreserved tickets, but as you can see, the train is pretty empty. There were no issues getting a seat, which is... So we made it on our plane. Kind of small, but cozy, you know. Got our snacks, our drinks, and ready for Hiroshima. No return after this point. Hiroshima. The flight was great. We ended up taking Ibex Airlines, and the plane was small, but the seats were really comfortable. There was a lot of leg room. Just really nice flight. Oh, and we got a free drink, which is very rare near Japan. So now we are waiting in line. We have our bus tickets that'll take us to Hiroshima City. Into Hiroshima City! Caleb doesn't want to be in this clip, but I'm forcing him. So Hiroshima City is about... Come back!
Unbelievable.
So we ended up taking a bus from the airport to Hiroshima City. It's about 45 minutes. Now we are going to head to our Airbnb because it is time to check in. Let's go. So because it's getting a little bit later, we decided to stop at the Dome and the Peace Park first. So that is where we are headed now.
And that is the eternal flame. He said that it will keep burning until all atomic bombs in the world are destroyed. Now we're heading to the museum.
Yep. Just left the Soldiers Memorial. We saw the eternal flame. We made it into the museum. We paid for our tickets. They were 200 yen each. And then they gave us these postcards made from recycled paper cranes from the Peace Monument. So pretty. So we just finished walking through the museum, and it was just like the Holocaust Museum Memorial in DC. It was such a great way to memorialize the bombing.
It was a little smaller than I had hoped it to be. Now I understand that part of it is under renovations and closed down, so there's not quite as many things on display, but it was still a good presentation, very narrow, a little crowded. We actually made two trips, the second trip being much better. We initially went at 4 and came back later about 5:30.
Yeah.
So so the second trip was a lot better. Some of the pieces were very poignant.
Yeah.
And especially the spot of the shadow of the burned victim, flash burn shadow that was on display. That was pretty surreal, I think.
Yeah, just to see hair that was burned off of victims and old clothing that they found just all over the city, and old lunch boxes and what else? Old fingernails and skin. Besides the size and besides it being a little cramped, I really feel like they did a good job of kind of piecing together everything and putting it into one piece so that you could really get an idea of how the bomb affected the city of Hiroshima. I definitely think that when you come to Hiroshima, going to the museum is a must see. It's definitely needs to be part of your trip here, because I feel like you can't really, even with a dome, you can't really get a sense of what it was like after the bomb unless you go see the pictures and just all the stuff that they have at the museum.
With that being said though, the Holocaust Museum and both in Israel and in the US and in DC, I thought were done better. I thought they were definitely larger. Not to take away from this museum, but don't get your hopes up too much that there's going to be a lot to see. It's pretty small, and again, it's only 200 yen, so that kind of helps make up for it. But compared to some others that we've been to, I think I actually like some of the other ones better.
Yeah, I feel like for Japan, I feel like this was probably one of the best museums in Japan. Enter. Exit. Okay. Dark hallway.
Welcome.
Welcome to our Airbnb.
Basically.
Wow. So it's a lower bed. More Japanese style than some of the other ones we stayed at. But look at this decor. I feel like I'm in Africa. We're no longer in Japan. We're in the jungle.
Check out this view.
Wow.
OMG.
Oh, pretty nice view. Step out onto the balcony. This is our view from our private balcony. I feel like I'm back at the Grand Hotel.
Yeah,
not. Nothing will ever compare. If you haven't watched our Grand Hotel vlog, click the link above. We got a Caleb. Let's see what else. Oh, what? Okay, so here we've got some Kit Kats, a TV, a fridge with our Wi-Fi password, some nice table salt and pepper for when we do some cooking tonight.
Nah.
A nice full-length mirror. And let's check out the bathroom. Huh. Pretty small, but not too shabby. Our first bud sighting.
Bud. We're hoping the whole tree would be bloomed. Like that. But it's like that instead. So it's Hiroshima, it's not dead, it just hasn't bloomed yet. It's not warm enough. Not warm enough.
But it is warmer than Tamura.
Yeah, it's like mid-50s.
Yeah, it's really comfortable.
Very comfortable. So wish it wasn't so hazy and cloudy.
Usually I'd be wearing gloves, scarf, and a hat. But I'm only wearing my raincoat. It's a miracle. So we are walking back to the Peace Memorial Park. And we're going to take some more pictures. And then we're going to go find some dinner. So there's no real description for this one, but it's pretty obvious what this is. A mother holding her dying child. And then surrounding it are hundreds, I think almost, maybe thousands of paper cranes. They're so beautiful. Such a beautiful reminder of such a sad thing that happened to the city. I remember in elementary school we read the book, A Thousand Paper Cranes. And I remember being so sad when we read the story. And I think there was a movie made about it. But it's so incredible that I'm here. And I never thought that I would ever come to Japan and actually see the site of the bomb. It's kind of, it's a little bit overwhelming, but I feel honored that we could come here and see just the memorial that they've made for the people that were affected by the bomb.
These are all the names and photographs of the victims of the atomic bomb.
So behind me is the Genbaku Dome. Genbaku actually means atomic bomb. So this is the atomic bomb dome in Hiroshima. And they kept this part of the destruction as a memorial of what happened, of the bombing, and just the destruction that the city endured. So it's pretty crazy to see that this structure is still here, even though the bombing happened so many years ago. But
how does it make you feel?
I feel kind of emotional. I feel like it's important to remember the past, and this is an amazing way to experience history. And I mean, like, you learn about it in school and you read about it, but it doesn't compare to actually coming here and seeing it in person.
Probably the most memorable or most notorious landmark of what happened August 6th, 1945.
Yeah. So Hiroshima is famous for oysters, so we found a random restaurant that was selling oysters. So we ordered 1 kilo, we got 12 oysters, and then we also ordered some deep fried oysters. And I think we're only getting 2. We're not sure how much was in that order. So our first order of the night has come. These are the deep fried oysters, and pretty sure, yeah, it's only 2 in an order. So they look pretty good.
Some lemon.
Is that tartar sauce, do you think?
Yeah, it says tartar sauce on the menu. Oishii.
Yeah. It's good.
Not too hot.
Oh, good.
Nice and crispy.
Nice.
Kilo of oysters have arrived, steaming hot. Kelly's excited. Not sure how many we have in there. Probably a dozen or so.
Yeah, it said 12.
Yeah, not going to be a ton. Not going to be super filling, but this is the quintessential Hiroshima food. This and okonomiyaki, so we're probably going to get okonomiyaki after this.
Yeah, probably still be hungry.
Yeah. Here's the sauce.
What is it? What do you think is? Soy sauce? Yep.
Kelly's first oyster.
Look at that. Okay. Oh.
Is it good?
That is really good.
Tastes fresh?
Yeah. So smooth. I don't know why I've never had oysters before.
Steamed
oysters. Yeah, steamed oysters. I don't think this is just soy sauce.
Mm. Maybe it's oyster sauce.
Maybe. Yeah, maybe it's oyster sauce. Yeah, just like super salty and just really delicious.
Mm, tastes like the sea.
Yeah. It's not juice. So good.
Like all good things, it must end. That took us about
5 minutes?
5 minutes? I'd say about 2 minutes. Didn't last very long. We each got 6 oysters, so there are 12 in the kilo.
Yeah, it was more of like a snack, but it was like $20 for these oysters.
It was $18.90.
Yeah.
And not including tax, so yeah, probably $20. And then the fried oysters is another $5.99. Mm-hmm. So $30.
I'm still hungry. This is like an appetizer, but for the price of a full meal.
Yeah.
But they were so good. It was worth it. If you ever come to Hiroshima, you have to try the oysters. They're worth it. So this is the outside of the restaurant that we went to. It's on the second floor, and they do have an English menu available. So if you're worried because you can't read Japanese or speak Japanese, they have that option available, which is really, really nice. So we are going to wait in line at this place behind me, Nagataya. We're going to get some okonomiyaki. And we picked this place because there was quite a long line, and there still is a line now, so hopefully it's good. So we were seated at the bar, and it's right in front of where they're cooking the okonomiyaki. Okonomiyaki is a mixture of noodles, cabbage, pork, sometimes egg. We ordered an oyster okonomiyaki, and you can either get soba noodles or udon noodles. And we got the udon. And over there are the oysters. those oysters are for our okonomiyaki. I'm not sure which one is ours though.
Barbecue sauce.
Smells like a tangy barbecue sauce. What is that thing on top? I think it's seaweed flakes that are on top of that. And this is our okonomiyaki. So we ordered the oyster one. So let's try it out. Caleb is cutting our okonomiyaki in half. Ooh, that's so good. So the noodles are really soft, squishy, and then the green onions are really crunchy, and so is the cabbage, and the egg really is nice.
So day one of spring break is in the books.
That's right. It was a great success. We did everything we wanted to do in Hiroshima.
Yeah.
We ate really great food for dinner.
Yeah, we hit the... We follow this website, Tofugu, which lists the top three foods of each prefecture. So as we go to new prefectures, we try to have some of the different foods that are listed on there. So Hiroshima is famous for okonomiyaki and oysters. And I can't remember the third thing is eel on rice.
But it's not in season.
It's not really in season. It's more of a summer food. So we had the oysters, as you saw earlier, and the okonomiyaki. Both were delicious.
Yeah. Yeah, that okonomiyaki, I think it was only like the second time that I've had that dish. But it was definitely the best one that I've had. So we hope you enjoyed this vlog. We're really excited to share the rest of our trip with you. Be sure to check out our next few videos to find out where we go next.
Yes.
Give this video a thumbs up. And don't forget to hit that subscribe button.
We make new videos every Tuesday and Friday. And of course, because we're on spring break, we've got a bunch of our next, I'm not sure how many videos are all going to be our spring break trip through to the south of Japan. So follow along with us as we travel.
Yeah, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye.